Here I want to discuss two topics that are often misunderstood about entropy. First, let's look at the entropy change for an engine. So what I represent here is on a temperature entropy diagram. We have a Carnot cycle here where we go around the cycle in a direction indicated by the arrows. We have adiabatic steps, namely these two steps are adiabatic and reversible, so there's no entropy change for this cycle. And we're going to compare that to an approximation to a Carnot cycle, but where this step and this step are now irreversible. We're going around the cycle, but the entropy increases during this adiabatic step, and then the entropy increases during this adiabatic step. And we want to look at what's the entropy change for the engine. So in this first, the reversible adiabatic steps, the entropy change for this engine is zero. We're going around reversible steps. We're always going back to our initial point. However, the entropy change for this engine, where we have irreversible adiabatic steps, is also zero, because as we go around this cycle, for example, we always come back to this point, the exact same point. So even though the adiabatic steps are irreversible, the entropy change for the engine is zero because it's a cycle. Entropy is a state function. The second misconception is this idea of converting heat and work. So 100 joules of work can be converted 200 joules of heat continuously. And this is indeed true. This is possible. The reverse is not possible. So 100 joules of heat cannot be converted continuously to 100 joules of work. Large difference between heat and work. We cannot continuously convert heat completely to work, but we can actually convert work to more than 100 joules, and we could do this using a Carnot cycle, for example. We can convert 100 joules of work into 200 joules of heat that we can exhaust to, say, heat a room by running a Carnot cycle as a heat pump. And we can do this continuously, and it satisfies the first law, and it satisfies the second law. And an important thing to keep in mind, this is something that's continuous, that we can convert 100 joules of work into 200 joules of heat.